Hey guys, welcome back to Get Your Play Online. I am so excited that you all are here today. Today, for our summer programming, we're doing princesses and pirates and all sorts of different fantasy things. I am here to help you make a Rapunzel tower. So, this Rapunzel tower is made out of a paper towel holder. So I'm going to tell you all the things that you need for this fun arts and crafts. So first thing that you need is a paper towel holder. Next, I have some glue, some brown paint, some scissors, some tape, some curling ribbon. I've already cut some off of this. Three different colors of paper. You'll need green, purple, and pink. I also have a paper towel over here that I'm going to wipe my brush off on, and I'm also going to put my paint on. And then the last two things that we need before we can get started is we need a paintbrush and we need a cup with some water in it. So let's just dive right into this. I'm super excited about today's activity. So the first thing that we need to do is we need to take our paper towel holder and we need to grab our paint and we need to put some paint on our paper towel. So I'm just going to get my area a little bit better set up. Now I'm going to show you what I'm doing. So over here I have my I've already put on my paper towel, and I'm going to grab my paintbrush. I'm getting all of the water off it right here on the towel, and I'm going to grab my paper towel, and I'm just gonna start painting it. I'm painting my paper towel brown because Rapunzel's tower, to me, it looks like a darker shade of brown. For this, you could change this up and you could make a yellow tower. You could make a white tower. You could make a red tower. Whatever color tower that you want, this is what you should be doing. So I'm just getting a lot of the brown on the paper towel, making sure I'm getting it all covered. And you also can notice that I have my fingers inside of the paper towel. This makes it easier for me to roll with my paint. So here I am, I'm just going back and forth with my brush, making sure that I am getting everything covered in brown. I'm just going to rotate with my fingers, and I'm going to just paint the rest. So, if this is your first time ever coming to Get Your Play Online, we are a platform on different social media outlets that we like to make sure that kids just like you are having fun while they're at home, while they're at friends' house, wherever they may be. Sometimes we do arts and crafts like this. Other times we can do some cooking or some baking. We can do get moving. One of the girls also, she has a dog, and that is so fun to be able to watch her do some cool dog tricks that she has planned out. So I really think that you guys should make sure that you log in at other times or look back on old videos to see what all we have done here on Get Your Play Online. So I just added some more brown paint to my paper towel because I ran out. That's okay. I just put some more on. So I'm just finishing up with painting my paper towel. I'm almost done. Also, make sure that you have paint that's washable because then it comes easier off your hands or whatever surface you're using. So now you can tell that my paper towel is completely brown now. So that's done. I'm going to set it to the side. I'm also going to set my paper towel with the paint over so I don't get messy on anything else.
So now if we're looking back at our Rapunzel tower, I am going to start making the leaves. So if I'm doing the leaves, what color paper do you think I need? The green, exactly. So I'm going to grab my green piece of paper. So here I have it.
I'm just going to
cut a few strips, so a few straight lines, just like so, for the vines that I'm going to wrap around my Rapunzel tower. So I'm going to do two. We may have to later on cut some more, but that is a-okay. Next, I'm just going to cut out, it's kind of a bigger strip of piece of paper, and I'm going to use this to make some of my leaves. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut a piece just like so. I'm going to fold it. If you've watched some of my videos before, you know that I love to do this because that means we get two pieces of paper by doing one thing. So I'm going to cut my leaf out, which to me kind of looks like a football, if you're familiar with that. So I'm just cutting it like so. And these are my two leaves. Since I was able to fold it, I have two leaves instead of one. So I'm going to set those off. I'm going to get my paper again. I'm going to cut this in half, which means that I just make two instead of one. I'm going to fold it again. And I'm going to cut out a bigger leaf for this. Again, I'm making kind of a football shape, but I can also see that maybe it looks like a flower petal, whatever you think it looks like. This is the last time that I'm going to take my piece of paper. I'm folding it, and I'm going to make another football, flower petal, maybe a lemon slice or an orange slice. And there we go. Now, since we were able to fold our pieces of paper, we have 2, 4, 6 leaves. You do not have to make that many, or you can make more. Depends on whatever you want. So now, for right now, we are done with the green. So I'm setting the green paper off to the side. Next, I am going to get my purple piece of paper. And I'm going to cut another strip. But this one I'm making bigger than the ones we did for the vines. Next, I am just going to cut one square and then two squares. And now what we're actually making is shutters. The shutters on the side of the window of Rapunzel's tower. So what shutters do is with the princess's tower, she can close these so then the window is shut. So for this, if you have a marker or you have a crayon or you have a pencil, you are more than willing and able to just draw the shutter on the piece of paper before you cut it out. Well, I'm just going to do it freehand. So I'm looking at my other Rapunzel tower to see exactly how I did this. So for this, the easiest thing for me to do is to just go straight up and then cut kind of like a curve or a half smile and just go up to the corner or the point of the square. This is kind of what I end up with. So for the other one, we're going to be doing the same thing. We're just going to go up, going to make a slight curve or a slight smile, go to the corner or the point, and there we go. These are our two shutters. Just like that. So I'm setting my purple scraps to the side and moving on to the next. So the next part of our Rapunzel tower, if you can see, is the simple triangle roof. So for this, you could do this different ways. You could make a cone, and you could stick the cone on top of the toilet paper or the paper towel roll, or you could just do what I did and just make a simple triangle. I'm going to show you how to just make a simple triangle. So here I have my piece of paper. You can already tell that I'm reusing paper. This is the triangle from earlier. So I'm going to use the other piece, or the other side of the piece of paper, and I'm just going to go up from that side and go up from this side to make a triangle. Kind of looks like a pizza slice. I don't know what you guys think, but it reminds me of pizza. I must be hungry. So now we have the different paper pieces of our paper towel folder. So we're going to just go and we're going to look at this. I'm just touching it to see if it's dry. There looks like there's some spots that are still drying, so we're just going to continue to set that to the side. The next part is probably my favorite part of this activity. This is when we take our curling ribbon that we used a few weeks ago on a different live that I had. And we're just going to cut off a few pieces. I'm going to cut off this one. I'm going to measure it to see if it's the same. I'm going to take that. And I'm going to grab the third piece. And I'm going to make sure it is the same length. The reason why we want to make sure it's the same length is for what we're about to do, it makes it a little bit easier. So we are going to learn how to braid these. If you don't have curling ribbon at home, another thing that you could use for Rapunzel's braid is yarn. Yarn is an easy material to work with and it's super, super fun. So now what I'm going to do is I'm taking my tape and I'm just taking off a small piece like so. I have some brown paint on my fingers from painting the toilet paper roll. So I'm going to just kind of line all of these ends up. I will show you in a second as I get it ready. Just like this. They're all together. I'm going to take my piece of tape. I'm going to make sure all of them are stuck together. Then I'm going to use the side of the table that I'm using. And I'm just pressing down the tape, making sure it's staying really, really good. Next, I'm going to get my tape again. And I'm going to use a bigger piece of tape, about this size. And I'm going to put it on the edge of my table, so it's not completely down, but that I can grab it quick. So what we're going to do now with these three pieces of curling ribbon is we are going to braid them. So when you're braiding, you have three different pieces, and what you're going to do is you're going to crisscross them. You're going to crisscross them so then they make a cool design. So the first thing that I'm going to do, I'm going to take the far right piece of string. Or this could be the one that is in your right hand, or the one that's closest to your door. You're going to pick up this one. Next, I'm going to take this piece, and I'm going to cross it over the middle one. So now the middle piece is in my right hand. Next, I'm going to take the left piece, and I'm going to cross that over the middle piece. So you go back and forth with alternate. I'm going to do a little bit so I can kind of show you the design. So this is kind of what it looks like. There's some braiding that's going on right now. This might be able to be seen a lot better with some yarn. But again, I'm just taking the right piece, going over the middle, left piece, going over the middle, right, middle, left, middle, right, middle, left, middle. Now I'm just going to keep doing this all the way down until I have no more ribbon left. So right over the middle piece, left over the middle piece, right over the middle piece, left, right, left, right, left, right, left. The really good thing about using yarn or curling ribbon is that if you mess up, you can just undo it and you can just keep trying to get it done. So I'm just going to finish out the bottom of this. Looks like my Rapunzel braid is going to be quite a bit longer than the one I made earlier. So I'm almost to the bottom. I'm just going over the right and then the left and then the right and then the left. And then I'm just going to call that good. So now I have at the end piece some of these straight ones. I'm going to just chop right off right now. Don't need those. And take my piece of tape. And I'm going to, on the end of my Rapunzel braid, I'm just going to put that tape over itself and make sure that it's staying really good. I'm just squashing it. I'm going to use another piece of tape. Small one like this, and I'm just going to make sure that all the tape is down. So that looks pretty good to me, but that doesn't mean we're done yet. Now we have this end that was on the table, so we need to make sure that all of that stays together too. All right, looks like we have our Rapunzel braid. This is so exciting. And again, it was not my first time that I had braided. I have been braiding for years, so that's why I was a little bit quicker. But I promise you that with practice and with trying again and again, you will be able to braid. So I'm going to go back to my Rapunzel tower, and I'm going to see if it's dry. Good news, friends, it is dry. That means we are ready to start gluing on our other items. So I have my tower here, and if you notice something with a paper towel holder is that there are these lines that are kind of following up the whole entire thing, like so, and that is such an important thing to notice because we're going to put our vines right on those. So I'm grabbing my glue, and I'm going to either, I can put the glue right on the toilet paper roll, or the paper towel roll, silly me, or I could put it on my vine. So for the first one, I'm going to just put it on the actual paper towel roll. My glue isn't open. But for this, you really don't have to put that much glue on. They tend to stay pretty well. So I'm just using the green piece of paper that I cut from my vine. And I'm just putting this on, making sure I'm pressing that it's staying on. And then I'm going to keep going up. And keep following up until I don't have any time left. Now. I'm using Elmer's glue, so it looks like it's white right now, but it will dry clear. Kind of like magic in that sense. So I'm just going to keep holding it to make sure that the ends are going to stay on my paper towel roll. And now that we were able to do this, this is where part of the project that's a little bit trickier and will require parent supervision is needed. So now that we know where the vine is on our tower, we get to decide where we want Rapunzel's window to be. So you could use a marker to put a direction where you want to go, or you could just try to go wherever. So I'm going to, this is really sharp, so please make sure that you have parents watching or someone that is older. So I'm going to just hold my paper towel right this. I'm going to use my scissors just to cut a little hole for a window for Rapunzel. Make sure that your fingers are not completely down because you don't want to accidentally cut yourself. So I'm making a smaller window this time. When I made one earlier, it was a little bit bigger. This is just going to be a little window for Rapunzel. So now I have my piece cardboard. I'm going to just set that off the side. Now I just have this hole, which is where she has her hair down for her tower. So now that we have that done, we can decide that if we want to do more vines. So with mine, I think that I'm good with the vine for the most part of it. But I want to put a little bit more up here. So I'm going to get my glue, and I'm actually just going to connect them, I guess. Put some glue gently around it. And I'm going to grab my vine. And I'm making sure that it is where the glue is, where I want this all to be. And now I have too much, so I'm just going to cut the rest of the vine off. So this is what my tower looks like right now. So the next thing that I'm going to do once this vine is sticking is I'm going to hold this, make sure it's sticking very well, and I am going to put on the leaves. So if you remember that earlier we made 6 leaves, and we get to put these wherever we think they look good. Alright, so that looks like it's sticking. We're going to go back and we're going to grab our leaves. I'm just going to put a little dot of glue on my leaf. And I'm going to look. I think that looks like a good spot for a leaf. I'm going to grab my other leaf. And put this one a bit lower. Make sure it's sticking. And my other 4 leaves. Put a dot of glue. And put it up there. So you can put these leaves wherever you want them to go. I just think that right now, I think these look good where they're at. And I don't think I'm going to use the last 2, I guess. So now this is kind of what I am working with, is this. So next I'm going to be putting the shutters on. So with shutters, you want the straight, long edge to be right where the window is. So I'm just going to grab my glue, and I'm just going to put a thin line of glue right there. And grab my shutter, and I'm going to just hold it right there, right where my window is. Make sure it sticks. I'm going to repeat that and do it on the other side. So I'm going to go to the other side of the window and do a small line of glue. I'm going to line up the long straight edge to the window. And I'm going to hold it to make sure it sticks. You're almost done. This was so much fun. I'm so glad that you guys all are tuning in today. Next, we have a roof, just a simple triangle. So I'm going to put the glue up at the top. And I'm just going to hold the roof right there. Earlier when I was doing this, it took a little bit longer for the glue on the roof to dry. So this might be a time during the activity where you might have to practice some patience to make sure that it stays. If you have access to hot glue, you are more than welcome to be doing these steps with hot glue instead of Elmer's glue. But if not, this glue is working out really well. Alright, so that looks like it's sitting pretty good. And then I'm so sad, but this is our last step. It's already time. So I have my braid. So the last thing I need to do is I need to get this braid in my Rapunzel tower. So I'm going to use tape. You can try with glue, but you might be holding your finger there for a while. So it's easiest for me if I put the tape on my braid before I put it in the Rapunzel tower. And then I'll put it in the Rapunzel Tower and I'll just kind of squeeze it to make sure it's there. And this is my final product.
This is what I ended up with. This is my Rapunzel Tower. Her hair is very long. I tried today to get some Rapunzel hair going on, but I think that she does it a lot better. But I am so happy that you were with me today and we did these super fun Rapunzel Towers. I'm so excited that hopefully you'll continue to watch some of our videos. Make sure that you log in later tonight for some bedtime stories. And I just want to say thank you so much for being here today on Get Play Online. My name is Jalen, and I'm so happy that you're here. Make sure that you enjoy these Rapunzel Towers. See ya!